UK, United Kingdom. So the pilot in command for the today's flight is Captain Nishtha, along with the crew member Sajana. So over to you, Dr. Nishtha.
Thank you, Manbir. Hello, everyone. So you're ready for the tour today to UK?
Yes,
Yes?
ma'am.
All right. Okay. So let's start the tour. So the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland is commonly known as the United Kingdom or Britain. It is a sovereign country in the northwestern Europe off the northwestern coast of the European Midland, I mean mainland, I'm sorry. The United Kingdom is a unitary parliament democracy and constitutional monarchy. The monarch, Queen Elizabeth II, has reigned since 1952. So Queen Elizabeth has been ruling there since 1952. The United Kingdom consists of four countries: England, Scotland, Wales, and Northern Ireland. Now the map of United Kingdoms. The United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland, that is the UK, is an island country that sits northwest of the mainland Europe. It is made up of mainland Great Britain. Now, Great Britain comprises of what? England, Wales, and Scotland, as well as the northern part of the island of Ireland, that is the Northern Ireland. It has numerous smaller islands there. The UK is low-lying in the east. It has mountains in the north of England, in Scotland, in Northern Ireland, and in Wales. The population there, according to the 2018 report, is 66 million. And the area is 242,500 square kilometers. Now, the flag of the United Kingdom. The Union flag has elements of all parts that form the UK. So, which are those parts? We just saw those four parts, right? So they all, you know, the elements of all those four parts are there in the flag of UK. The national flag of the United Kingdom is the Union Jack and is also known as the Union Flag. The design of the Union Jack dates back to the Act of Union 1801, which united the Kingdom of Great Britain and the Kingdom of Ireland to create the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland. The flag consists of the Red Cross. Now, there are three main crosses here in the flag. So, which are they? One cross denotes Saint George, the patron saint of England, which is edged in white. Then it is superimposed on the cross of Saint Patrick, patron saint of Ireland, and it is superimposed on the I'm sorry, yeah, on the saltire of Saint Andrew, the patron saint of which place it is? It is Scotland. So there are three crosses here actually. Okay, now the capital of UK or the United Kingdom is London. So London is the capital and the largest city of England and the United Kingdom. The city stands on the River Thames in the southeast of England at the head of its 50-mile estuary leading to the Northern Sea or the North Sea. London has been a major settlement for 2 millennia and was originally called Londinum. Okay, it's Londinium actually, which was founded by the Romans. So it was originally called what? Londinium, and it was founded by the Romans. Now the pound, the currency of United Kingdom. The official currency of the United Kingdom is the British pound or the Great Britain pound. Am I properly audible to everyone?
Yes, madam.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, great.
Very
Thank you.
clearly.
Okay, thank you. So it was used in Great Britain, British Overseas Territories, the South Sandwich Islands, and the British Antarctic Territory, as well as Tristan da Cunha. Yeah, it's a weird name actually, but it's Tristan da Cunha. Yes, Abir.
The British Antarctic Territory.
Yes.
Very
It is
funny.
used in these places. Yes, actually. But this currency of, UK, which is the pound, I'm sorry. Yeah, it is used in these places. Where in Great Britain, British Overseas Territories, the South Sandwich Islands, and the British Antarctic Territory, as well
British
as
Antarctic Territory, that's what I was asking about.
Yes. Okay, so what about it?
I'm thinking that it leads all the way to Antarctica.
Yeah, it does actually. Okay, and this is the last one is Tristan da Cunha. Now, I don't know if there is any other pronunciation to it, but this is what I know. Now, the pound is divided into 100 pence. So, 1 pound is equal to 100 pence there. Another name used for the pound is sterling. So, we also call that.
What's up, guys? My name.
So, here we come to the end of this tour now. So, who is the Prime Minister? Can anyone tell me? Of United Kingdom?
Boris Johnson.
Yes, of course, that's right. And what else? What else? Anything anyone wants to tell me? Okay, one more thing I'll tell you all. There are more chicken in United Kingdom as compared to the people there. Yes, that's true. Okay, yes. Any fact anyone wants to share with us? No one? All right, over to Manbir ma'am and Sajana.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Nishtha, for such a wonderful session. I hope all the guests enjoy today's tour to the UK. Yes, Anj.
Ma'am, I have one fact about England.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, England has the shortest history for the war.
Okay. All
And
right.
one more fact I'll share is French was the official language for around 300 years in United Kingdom. English became the official language later on. Okay, yes, Manvi, please.
Okay, so on Monday we will be visiting Vietnam, and that is the last tour. So beside that, we'll have a little farewell as well. So it is mandatory for everyone to join that particular tour, as that is the last tour of our event. So I hope you have enjoyed this event with us. So we'll see you on Monday. And for Monday, I have a task for you all. You have to search about the flag of Vietnam, and you can draw it, color it, or paint it. All right. Yeah, okay. Okay, so we'll see you on Monday. Bye, everyone. Have a good day.
Bye everyone. Take care.
Bye, ma'am. Have a good day.
Bye everyone.
Manmir, what about tomorrow?
Oh, I'm really sorry. I just missed
Manmir?
it. Hello. I'll
Yeah.
just. I just give it a reminder in the group.
Because tomorrow is like you must be having one country, na? Tomorrow is Friday.
Okay, I'll just give one Vietnam is on Monday, so tomorrow is USA. I'm really sorry, I just skipped it.
Right. That's very important country.
Yeah.
Okay.
So tomorrow is USA and on Monday is. Okay, so I'll give a reminder.
Right. Got it. Shall we end?
Yeah.